Giant green sea turtles covered in tumors. It's difficult to look at. And experts tell us the disease is actually painful for the animals, too. Jen Benise is tonight with more on what scientists are doing to help. Jen?
Dash, experts tell me the disease that causes the tumors is called fibropapilloma, and it affects green sea turtles worldwide. It was first found here in Hawaii in the 1950s. Biologists are continuing to study the virus, but they still have more questions than answers. I met with wildlife disease specialist Terry Work. He's been studying turtles with fibropapilloma for 20 years. It causes both external and internal tumors, mostly in green sea turtles. I'm told animals with the disease are in a great deal of pain.
If you get enough of these tumors, you start malfunctioning, basically. So it impedes swimming, it impedes, you know, breathing, eating, and they kind of waste away and die.
I wanted to know what's causing it.
So there's really good evidence at the molecular, the microscopic level, that there's a herpes virus that's associated with these tumors. We've never really been able to prove that.
Work tells me finding that piece of the puzzle is key.
So there's a lot of effort in the lab trying to grow the virus, and we're also trying to develop a blood test. If we can find a blood test, we can take a blood sample and say, hey, this animal's been exposed, the virus is circulating, then it gives you more time to intervene.
So are there any environmental issues that may be causing this?
There could be. I mean, clearly with any disease, whether it's fibropapilloma or AIDS or anything else, there's always an environmental component to it. But what that environmental component is, we're not really sure.
I'm told cases of the disease increased in the 90s, but have since tapered off. Work says some turtles may have developed an immunity. But again, he says that has not been proven.
The wildlife is telling us something. There's something about the environment or about these animals that are making them predisposed to these tumors. And we should pay attention to that and try to get to the bottom of it.
The virus is transmissible, so infected turtles can spread it to other turtles. Humans cannot get the disease. Back to the desk.